Fair.
All right.
We disagreed
awesome.
It with Sean, but yeah.
Donk, Sean, hey you, whatever. Whatever works. All right.
Okay, have a fun time.
All right, thank you very much. Well, hi, everybody. My name is DonkeyShaunJr, and I love to play retro games, and I am very honored to be part of this charity stream tonight. I'll be going from midnight until around 2 a.m. What's up, Channel 3 Live? How you doing? I got a whole bunch of games planned. I have three definites and maybe a fourth if I'm fast to get through this. I do want to talk a little bit about donations. I already see I got one as soon as it came. Chad Broke, I can't take requests, but I will sing a song just for you. This is a demo. If you donate any amount of money, I shall sing you a song. I do have some singing ability. So this one is for Chad. I'm going to mess it up. Chad Brookie Chill 17. Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a pal and a confidant. And if you threw a party, inviting everyone you knew, you would see the biggest gift would be from me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. Well, thank you very much for the donation. Anyway, any amount that goes through, when I catch it, I will do my best to sing you a song. I have all kinds of wacky ones picked out. And hopefully, it'll come across well. But before we get into all that, let's play some Karnov. I'm not totally terrible at this game, but I'm not a speedrunner, so I will do my best to try to go through. If you've never played Karnov, you should totally check it out, because it's actually really fun. I'm already using one of my one of the tricks that Captain Wolf told me 5 seconds before I went live, about running to the right as far as you can. One of the fun things about this game is you can glitch the bejesus out of it a lot with some goofy tactics. Oh, I screwed up already. But it's one of my favorite games. As a kid, I used to play this all the time. And then I started to get pretty decent at it. But I am in no means like oh my god, I'm failing already. Ugh. I am in no means a speedrunner, as you can already tell. Hi, everybody who's coming into the chat. I hope that I will do my best to keep up with it. I'm not used to big fancy chats. I'm used to just streaming mostly by myself. Ugh! Stop it with this. I have a feeling Mr. Turbo button's gonna get turned on eventually because, oh my god, I'm failing miserably right now. On the first level, nonetheless. I think there's a health thing back this way. Ah, oh, no, you don't. But Karnov is one of my favorite games. Actually, fun fact, if you ever get the chance to play the Famicom version actually has a story. So apparently Karnov was a wizard or some crap, or a fire-breathing magician or something, but he was a jerk in real life, so when he died, he went to hell. But this dragon ascended on the town where Karnov is from, and stole this crystal or some shit, so everybody's in misery. So God came down to Karnov and said, I will get you out of hell if you defeat Ryu the dragon. Which is weird, because Karnov's Revenge is a side fighting game, and I've always wondered if the Ryu connection was some kind of weird Street Fighter thing. Think about it. Duh! Man, I am playing poor tonight. I apologize. I'm usually less terrible than this. That's alright, we'll get it back. Just take some time. There we go. Slightly better now. I'm pretty sure Mr. Turbo button's getting turned on in a few seconds. I don't know why, but when I was really little, those guys that are on those floating clouds always used to creep me out. And those enemies, those gold dudes, are the worst guys in the game if you can't kill them fast enough. Because if you can't kill them fast enough, they're guaranteed to destroy you. I'm glad most people know. Most people, if you're watching this, you gotta have some connection to retro gaming, so you got an idea. That's weird. This game is also programmed by Data East, so it has suspect programming. Here's a trick. As soon as this guy spawns, just duck, and you can rip him apart. Pro tips. Sometimes I have weird problems on this level. I don't know why. It gets weird. Mostly because you got this YOLO jump right in the beginning. And you get ahead of the screen. The screen is too fast, too far ahead. And then you got this guy who's just waiting to pounce on you. I definitely thought I was going to get hit on that one. I walked into that one. There we go. Oh my god, are you see? That's what I get for cat. I got caught looking in the chat window. Oh! Ninja Shmoo, I owe you a song. Hold on a second. Alright, for you, I have a. Let's do the Zack Attack song. We'll do the song that was written by Zach, the Zach Morris Friends Network. We'll be friends forever. We're friends until the end. Thank you so much for the donation, Ninja Shmoo. We're friends until the end. Till the end. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I literally walked into that death. That was really embarrassing. Something happens when you're like, I've played this game on my stream a million billion times, and then I get here, and now I'm all like, derp. How do I Karnov? What kind of Karnov is this? Gotta make sure I pick up all the k in the game. It's very important. Coming up is one of my favorite bosses. You get to fight this giant T-Rex. Now, all these pro guys that actually have like skill are able to kill him with a boomerang. I don't have that skill, but I use this thing called the ladder tactics. It was invented by one of my best friends live on one of my streams. Where we invented this. There used to be a thing here, but I guess I'll just deal with that. Where you just go back this way and put up the ladder, and then you can just wail on this guy. That's ladder tactics. I love that move. That's one of my favorites. I can't believe I've died twice. This is horrible. Karnov's gonna come to my house and beat me up. Stop sucking at my game. This level has some weird stuff in it sometimes. Once again, just walking into things. It's the game, it's laggy. It's my controller, it's broken. It's always the controller's fault. Dude. I'm blowing it. Tilts have been known to happen before. I have been known to have salt meltdowns. Just gotta hang out here for a second. Wow, really? Oh, that's so sad. That's the first time I've continued on this game in a long time. Balls. Alright, that was a warm-up game, so let's just get real. Let's get serious here. I got killed by the meatballs. That's even worse. There we go. Now we're slightly less terrible. I do not remember those guys showing up there before. I wonder if that means the volcanoes are going to be active. That might be it. I might be getting volcanoes, live volcanoes coming up here. Because sometimes these things attack and sometimes they don't. I'm just going to hang out for a minute, because usually he's supposed to throw two, and he's not. Alright. Methinks I might be having a struggle right now. The vulture thing's the only thing I've ever figured out, Sanjian, is I just run past them. That's the only trick I've ever come up with that's effective on those guys. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Now I got five of those guys. Now they're spawning here. Alright, new plan. Eat that in the name of America. Are these gonna go off? Cause like, oh, see? This time they went off. Usually, most of the time they only go off if they don't go off at all. I need to pick up some shoes while I'm here, so I might as well. Thank you. You know, I gotta give also props to Karnov because he's, you know, representing full-figured men. Which I feel we are underrepresented. And I appreciate that. Alright, here's a pro tip. I don't have turbo on, so I don't know if I can kill her in one shot, but you can do some serious damage by doing this! What's up, sweet meat? I love this game too, it's one of my favorite. Isn't he in a fighting game? Karnov's Revenge or something? Isn't it a side fighter? I love this game. It's so bizarre, but fun. Alright, new plan, hang on. Mr. Turbo Button has made an appearance. Now this is slightly less frustrating. I get to fight the dinosaur again. I need to get an extra life out of this. There we go. These guys are really annoying too, because their attacks are really hard to dodge. Like right now, I'm just having trubs lining them up. Sometimes he does, if you have the diving helmet, you can turn in more into a mermaid-like creature. But it's hard to, like... That's the only thing it does, it just makes you swim faster. And most of the time I find I mess up more. Because it's like too fast. Suddenly I feel like I'm playing Jaws, but I'm the shark. I love Jaws. That's one of my favorite games too. I don't know if anybody else is a Jaws fan. The NES version of Jaws is actually a great game. Yo! This guy is coming out of nowhere on me. There we go. Alright, now I gotta be careful here, because you can get stuck in this wall sometimes. Alright, I survived that glitch. And now I gotta... Ladder tactics! Woo! Oh! Mr. Falcon, or Dom Falcon, or is it Dame Falcon, or Dam Falcon? I'm not sure, but I owe you a song! What song should I do? Let's do this one. You're simply the best! Better than all the rest! Better than everybody else! Thank you so much for the donation, you're the best! Oh, so Dom Falcon. Thank you. Very much for the donation. I appreciate it. All donations, if you didn't hear in the beginning, I will sing a song of praise for you. The real trick with those guys is just don't shoot them. Because if you don't shoot them, they don't do anything to you. I mean, sometimes you gotta shoot them because they're like on your path, but... I don't know, those guys give me the most trubs. They're just fit. They give me fits. In this game, for some reason. I'm trying to think of other fun topics to talk about. So, the singing thing, I should mention that I did go to school for music. I was a music education major at a really small music school in New Jersey. That was all conservatory and opera based. I taught public high school music for a couple of years, but it wasn't for me. Not the teaching part. I love the teaching, but the part about like having to be in like organizations and like having to deal with the administration and all the standardized testing stuff that's in public schools just doesn't... It didn't jive with me. All right, I have a shield, so I don't really need... I don't think I need to get that one. Whoa. Where are you shooting at? Sometimes they show up, sometimes they don't. I love the student part. The student part was the best. Sometimes I just use the shield on this one because you can take 6 shots without getting hurt. And sometimes it's just easier. You just can't turn around. If you turn around, you can still get killed. But, yeah, it was a lot of fun. And, but now I don't really do singing stuff on the side, so I get to experience, like, the gig life, so to speak. It's not my primary job anymore, but, you get to go to experience a lot of fun things. And teaching public high school, you get to experience a lot of fun things. Like, fun and, like, terrifying at the same time. I think one of the more scary ones was I had a student who went into labor. That was pretty scary, because I was, like, 20... I was 21 or 22. And I had, you know, I don't know what I'm doing. I have no idea. I barely know how to dress myself at that point. That was pretty scary. That was not one of my better moments as a teacher. Because I basically just went, what the fuck? And just dialed. I was like, someone call 911. I don't know what to do. Like, am I supposed to boil hot water? I don't know. What am I doing here? Oh no, I fell down the steps. Coming up is some of the most annoying enemies in video game history. These guys. But you can once again use the ladder to your advantage. It's all about the ladder in this game, baby. And then this part, which as a young fifth grader was like, yeah, right, I can never forget how to do this part. So you jump here, and then, I screwed it up. But you gotta jump here, and then jump up here, and then that'll happen, and then you jump over this guy, and you fall down. Who's figuring this out in Karnov? And then what I do is I go back to my trusted ladder, and I get up here, and I can hit him, and he can't hit me, and I do these like really crazy hookshot move with my arm, and then I'm good. That is the truth. That, you know, in my defense, it wasn't like that's like a standard thing they go through in the handbook, how to deal with the pregnancy. I had that happen. One time we had, for the musical, we had a student. She got into she was in class, in the cafeteria, and a kid was, like, bullying her. So she turned around and smacked the Holy Spirit out of that kid. It was bad. So the day of, like, opening night, they had to, tell me that she couldn't be in the musical because she got suspended. That was really fun. It was more fun trying to explain it to her mom. Alright, I need to get the ladder here. Sometimes this thing... This Ooh, item system really? Is not the most fun. Oh, I didn't want to use that. Well, it doesn't matter. There we go. Because the shield on this guy is kind of a must. I mean, I guess if you're a beast... You could dodge his shots, I guess, but I don't know. There we go. But yeah, it was, that was an interesting one. Oh, thank you for the host! I saw host notification. Now, when I was a young kid, this was pretty much like the last level in the game. And I might still screw this up, because I've done this like a certain number of times, but... There's certain map parts in here where I get lost. That's alright. I can do this. Take that, machines. There we go. And basically, you just want to stay across the top. That's the thing I learned about this level. Just stay up top. And then you're pretty much fine. Even if you run out of wings, you're still okay. Cause you can actually bomb this wall and get more wings. There we go. And we'll hang out for this. And here we go, more bombs away, baby. I'm not getting any drop frames tonight, so the Comcast gods have sided with me for the moment. Although now that I've said that, I've definitely just jinxed myself. And then we take off into the wild blue yonder. And there's only one other item you need to get, which is the shield. No, 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 no! Stay away from me! You can go full out on this one. There we go. It's true. The Nintendo gods or the internet gods. There's two gods I need to pray to today. Alright, we've made it to the last level here. I have it done completely horrendously as I just spit seltzer all over the place, but I did continue once, which is slightly embarrassing, but I'll count that as a warm-up game. And it's going to get worse as I get into Splatterhouse, which is the next game that comes up on my list. And then, I don't know, I got a feeling I want to play Trojan, and I'm between that or Jackal, but I think I'm going to go with Trojan, or Trohan, as I like to say. And really, the trick in this level is just get up on this platform and just go to the right, and you're pretty much safe. Like, you don't really... There's only, like, one spot that you can screw this level up, which I definitely just jinxed myself to get through. Alright, here we go. That's the one jump that if you screw it up, if you fall... Because in this game, if you fall, you can't control yourself when you fall. You just kind of drift down. That's the only one. And this one, I guess, too. Which I just did. Lord. Don't tell me I'm gonna die. Alright, this is fixable. I can just go the slightly longer way. Of killing this guy. There we go. That's okay, that's okay. We recovered. We recovered. See what happens? I talk crap, and then... The Karnov lords were like, alright, the Nintendo gods were like, oh. Et tu, Brutus? But I made it, I'm safe, I'm safe. And then we get to fight the evil dragon Ryu. This boss fight is actually pretty easy. You just gotta be careful to not overextend. Duh. Eventually they'll turn, like if the enemy turns red, you can't hit it. So you gotta just dodge. Come on, meow. Oh, see, he's red, I can't do anything. I did it! You got the tea bag when you're done. Look, I don't know, that was an awfully long pause. Alright, well I beat Karnov tonight, that's good. I didn't totally fail in my first game, which is always my biggest fear. Alright. All in all, not the hardest game in the world once you kind of figure it out, but really fun game. And one of the only good Data East games, don't tell me Bad Dudes, because that game sucks. I don't care what anyone says. Game is trash. The Nintendo game. The arcade is all right. So I think I'm going to switch over to Splatterhouse. I do have a really, really, really... They do need to make a sequel, like a real sequel. Not like a... not a side fighter. I want Karnov 2. More Karnovian. Where, like, the dragon Ryu comes back and it's all crazy. All right, so I'm going to switch over to Wanpaku Graffiti. I have a short break screen with some cheesy elevator music that I'll put up so that you're not just watching an empty screen. So hang on 1 second, and I shall return very shortly in about 9 seconds. Alright, I am back with some Wanpaku Graffiti. If you're just joining in, my name is DonkeyShaunJr. And I love to play retro games. If you've never played this game, it's a really, really cute version of Splatterhouse for the NES. It was released only in Japan because Japan always gets the cool stuff and you get the garbage in the United States. And it's very fun. So that's me. I'm the dead guy. And then the Pumpkin King steals my woman. And I venture off. I think I have an axe. I'm not really sure. You can buy this repro like super cheap. And it's a very... It's like in that B category of games for me, gameplay-wise. The hit detection sometimes is really bad. And some, there's no, like, hit recovery. So, like, when you get hit, you can get hit, like, 9 times in a row. But I have a lot of fun with it. I think it's really cute. If you happen to be a retro gamer that has not, or a gamer that's never seen it, I would highly recommend checking it out. You can use an emulator if you want, but, you know, illegal. But you can acquire it somehow and play it. I will try to do the good ending. There's 2 endings in this game, so I'm gonna take a stab at trying to do the good one. This will be your grave. Ha ha ha. By the way, if anybody's just joining, I do have a donation incentive that if you donate any amount of money, I will sing you a song as a thank you. A song of my predetermined choosing. The game actually is kind of cool because it has a level up system, which is kind of neat for kind of a simplified game. The game feel, like, you know how certain games feel a certain way? The game feel in this is very loose. Like, it's very squirrely, I guess would be the best way to put it. It's not like the smoothness of, let's say, a Mario Brothers. You do collect candy for life, so it's kind of like a cutesy, little fun kind of, like, horror game, but not really. You do have to kill a lot of stuff because there is a, like I said, there's a leveling system, so you got to make sure you got leveled up because you get more health with every level. You can see that if I kill 3 more things without dying, I will go up. The jumping is very weird. Oh. Did anyone else catch that? Yes, I love Halloween-y kind of games, but not like jump scare games. I like kind of silly games. I love this part because that guy is definitely giving you the finger. And we get a little dance sequence here. I always kind of expected them to get a licensing deal with, like, Michael Jackson to do Thriller. It'd be so much fun. I don't really have anything I can do right now other than run back and forth. And enjoy the dance. And now the dancers come at me. Because they're offended for my lack of dancing. And he gives you the finger while he throws pumpkin balls at you. The only real hard part in this is just dodging that guy's shots. That. I walked right into that one. That was sad. Come on now. I guess I should just stand still and really not have to move that much. And then he gives you the piece. And then you're good. None of this game makes any sense. But there's some really fun tie-ins. You can kind of see why it never came to the United States. Not just because of the, There's some copyright issues that could come up, and there's some religious things in here that probably Nintendo wasn't a big fan of. Give me that candy. Now I get to fight Annabelle. I think Annabelle. No, I get to fight the books. A lot of the bosses in this game have this, like, this floating thing, and then they shake the screen to make it even more annoying. I'm holding on to that burger until the last second. Ah, oh, come on. I gotta stop doing that. I'm, like, camping out too close. Yay. The screen shake thing is like a Famicom thing, I think, in my mind. Oh my god, I love Monster in My Pocket. This fight is really annoying. This is where I get to fight Annabelle. This screen shake thing drives me crazy. Like, for some reason, it just messes with me. Sometimes you can get these things stuck in like a pattern, like I have right now. But I've never mastered the art of it. Ah! Did I do it? Oh, I killed him. They're like, they abandoned this side of the room. I'm like, I'm so confused. Stress! Whew! Alright, well, I beat that. That was exciting. And you'll see that fight more than once. The garbage of cesspool! Somebody write down that password in case I need it. 1055. And then we're back to more of this silliness. You know, another game is like, it's not Halloween, but it's Halloween-ish that I love. Bart's Nightmare for the SNES. Love that game. Underrated. People poop all over it, but I love it. I think it's a jolly romp of a set of minigames. Alright. We made it through the weird house. Now we're fighting the chickens and dodging the knives. They're headless chickens coming out of an oven. I really want to meet the game designer for this. I really want to know. What were the ideas behind this? I love Monster Party. I think it's... Oh, Monster Party's okay. I find it hard to play. Like, it's not the most polished game. But I like it. It's good. I just, this year for the first time for around Halloween, I did Sweet Home, the Famicom version. There's tons of really good English translations. And I like that game a lot. That was really good. A little repetitive, but not bad. You probably have to get it in English unless you're really good at reading Japanese, because it's kind of like a horror puzzle kind of game, RPG-ish. But it's actually like the father of Resident Evil, apparently. Alright, now this is the first level. You know how when you play Nintendo games, there's like that one level you get to where the game stops futzing around, and they're like, alright, you're a serious gamer, and now I'm gonna try to make your life miserable. That's this level. And these worm things are gross, and I'm standing in poop, and I don't really know how I feel about that. And the boss in this level is really annoying. I have a really hard time with this boss sometimes. I've been known to rage quit on this boss. Need some candy. Yay. When I get there, you'll see why. There's definitely a really frustrating part of this boss fight. I need that. Jump. Alright, here it is. So there's this really annoying wind, right? And I gotta go all the way to the right while this guy throws mice at me. Oh, this is so annoying. I hate this fight. And you gotta be real judicious. Oh, I'm gonna die. Fucking hell. I hate this boss fight. Shuts the door on you. Get out. You and your friends are dead. Game over. At least it's courteous enough to start you here. I think the problem is you have to be really judicious with your swings. Because if you swing, you can't move. And if you can't move, you get blown backwards. So you gotta be like dead on. But you only have to hit the boss once. Really? That hit me? Come on. Get me out of this poop water. All 90s video games were obsessed with sewers. I don't know why. No sewer actually looks like this. There's not just like pipes and poop liquid everywhere. I mean, obviously with my degree in sewer design. At least I got full health. This is it. This is getting beat right now. No more futzing around. There! Take that! I did it. The game's beat. The game's over. I beat it. What? That... I just got Nintendo'd. Or I guess Famicom'd, technically. Welcome to Devil Town! Your password is 3739! Thank you very much. I'm gonna mess this up. A Catharia. I tried, I'm sorry. I failed. I tried and I failed. At least I'm honest about it. I honestly did terrible. Now I get to fight the pumpkin kids. Most of this part- Whoa, I don't remember those guys. They're cockroaches in this level? Since when? I don't know, man. I turned 38 this week on Wednesday, and I think my brain really is starting to go. Alright, cat will work. That's alright, no one knows what to call me, because they're like, they're like, we'll call you Donkey, and then they're like, that sounds weird, so they'll just call me Sean. Call me Hey Idiot, I don't care. Whatever works. Oh yeah, I forgot about this part. I forget what I have to kill. Oh yeah, I have to kill the chainsaws. And not get hit by the one on the floor. Come on now. What? Ugh. See what I mean about there's no post-hit recovery? That can make this really, really difficult. Because sometimes you just get caught, like you just get snuck and then you're in a corner and you get hit four times instead of just once. Oh yeah, this is the part where it's the monsters from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. You'll recognize them. You remember them, right? And this would have been the part where, like, you know, the alien 20th Century Fox would have filed a lawsuit. It's Alien Isolation, the prequel. Ugh, getting shit on. This is totally random too. I don't think there's a way to force them to drop. Ugh. Sorry, I feel like I'm neglecting chat. I'm being a bad person. What's up, The Dork Gaming? I'm a bad streamer. I'm focused so much on the game because I don't want to blow it. All these people are watching me and they're like, wow, this guy sucks. I could totally beat this game with my eyes closed and he can't get past the aliens. Drop down. Do it now. Do it. I don't like these. I like these, like, the fight is interesting in that, like, I'm killing these monsters that are falling out of this woman. But, I don't like fights that are just endurance matches. Like, how many times is this gonna happen? Like, they need to change it up. Not make it harder, but just, like, different color aliens, something. I think it's a timed event. And then she gets up and she's like, I'm good. Yeah, we are getting there. Oh, I should mention, for those that are just joining in, If you do make a donation of any size, don't care, 10 cents, whatever. Come on, Sean. I will sing you a song as a thank you. I really don't remember there being cockroaches in this part, but whatever. There we go. Just running down the street, lobbing, swinging axes. I mean, they're generous with the life. I'll give them that. That's good. Oh my god, I forgot about the hell bell. This is the sound you hear when the apocalypse happens. Listen. This is scary as shit. I remember the first time I played this, it was midnight at a friend's house, and we had gotten a Famicom. And this whole scene was just really scary. I was like, we're going to hell, dude. This game is about devil worship. My mom saw this thing on Oprah Winfrey about magic cards, and they were satanic, and that was it. I was like, we're going to hell, dude. It's also probably the reason why I never showed up in the U.S. Because we're getting a little awkward with the religion. Hellbelly Deluxe. Rob Zombie. Yeah! You just gotta wait for these guys to swoop. And when they swoop, then you try to hit them. Not get hit like I am. You gotta kill him quick, because then this guy turns into a ram, and then it's like even more annoying. So sometimes you can get him caught in a loop. I think I might have got him in a loop. Take that, goat demon. I feel like I'm in The Exorcist. And then he breaks up into goat chunks and then you win. That was so much fun. Well, you know, they didn't know any better. There were a whole bunch of... Son of a bitch. There were a whole bunch of games that came out for the Famicom that I'm, like, really... I've always been really disappointed that they never made American ones. Holy Diver. I mean, I know, because of the copyright, it would be a nightmare, but... That one's just staying up there. Really. Alright. Do I go in here? Okay. Oh yeah, this is the one where they stole the whole scene from The Fly. Goat chunks. Can I sing in it? Hunky goats. Goat butter. No, that doesn't work. I don't remember this boss. Oh, I remember this boss. You gotta dodge the little boys that he shoots, and then you gotta hit him. You gotta hit him when he dives down. I'm doing a really good job.
Whoa!
Come on now. I don't think I've hit him once yet. Bruh. Okay. Let's focus here, shall we? And not die. I got him! One time. This is gross. He's shooting flies out of his body at me. How'd I not hit you? See, that's what happens. Like, you just get dunked on in this game sometimes. Ah, come on, man. Shh. That deserves some negative sound effects.
You blew it!
You blew it!
I blew it. I hit him twice. Or once, not even. Come on, Hag. Let's go. Let's be less terrible. Can I dunk on him right on the bat? No, I can't, of course. Game designer was too smart for me on that one. Alright, well, I'm doing slightly less horrible. Oh, that was it? I sliced that fool up. That's better. What's up, Trez? Diamond Lake. Ghost comes here with the ray. 8245. Somebody write that down. Somewhere there's a notebook in my basement with all of these passwords written down. This is the Crystal Lake ripoff, I guess. I love these really smug, fat bats that they have in this game. I love that sprite. It's just really funny looking to me. They're like bats with that, like, got in the garbage can. Uh-oh. Looks like somebody's got a gun. Whoa, what was that thing? That thing was a hell demon. Take that! Why didn't they give you the gun the whole time? Just some random pair of legs in the background. I think these things are a glitch, because I don't know why they're on the land. It's very strange. The shotgun is very fun, but you gotta be careful with it, because you can do that. You can knock yourself into oblivion with it. What's that thing? I love these. The sprites in this game are just so funny. Well, I guess it wasn't a glitch because they're up there. Totally meant to do that. All in the reflexes. I remember the first time I played this, this shark part drove me nuts. I struggled so much on it. I don't know why. It's not like it's like really that hard. Arr, love me! Wow, I got through. I didn't even get hit. That's the first time for that. Oh my god, then we got to fight the barbecue boss. I don't remember how this works. Ugh. You don't have to hit him a lot, but it's a really annoying fight. He fights you with a carving knife and a spork. Take that, you dingus. Not the most annoying fight, but it can be intimidating the first time you do it, because it's like, there's flashing, there's guys diving at you. I did it! Woo! He's Barbecue Man, that's what I call him. Because he's got the barbecue deal, and he kind of looks like he's wearing an apron, but he's all burnt up. Now I'm in Diamond Camp, Ghost House. 4722. Dose, dose. What time is it? It's 1 o'clock. I got all the time in the world. What? Alright, fine. This is the part in the game where it's like, whatever, I'm just trying to rush through to beat it. Like, you know. Now I'm in survival mode. What? That is so cheap. There's all these decapitated heads. His kappa was detated from his head. Thank you, Sanjian. You got monsters throwing plates. Who's throwing plates? I hope I was supposed to do that. Yeah, I was. Damn it. Oh my god, I remember this level. This part's really annoying. This is like run for your life room. Now we're back outside in the creepy forest with that sick beat. I blew that really badly. Can I get some health around here? Where's a burger when I need it? Come on, Sean. Dude! Maximum effort jumps. Gotta chop those trees down. That was the first time I realized it was an axe. I thought it was a board. I don't know how you make that jump. But they give you a piece of candy, so it evens out. 4722. Thank you very much for that password, because I'm going to start needing them now. What? Hit me on the ricochet. What kind of BS was that? But anyway. Oh yeah, now I get to fight Wolfman Jack. Rawr! Love me! I don't remember this part at all. I remember this part now. He's throwing fur balls at me, I think. Oh, come on! He dunked on me. You see that? He teabagged me in the ass. I did like Wolfman Jack. Alright, I'm down to my last continue on this run. Ruh-roh. Fortunately, we have passwords. See what I mean? Like, you just get hit three times in a row with, like, no recourse. Yeah, take that. And then the thing leaves. It's like, see, that was creepy. Hell House on the Hill. Can you get there or will you? Still, 7397. 7397. Almost there, almost at the end of the game. Thank you. I don't know why on earth you would go, just find a random hamburger in the middle of the floor and just eat it, but whatever. I guess you're already dead, so it doesn't matter. Why is this so goofy? Really? This is where using the shotgun can cause problems. There we go. Especially here. Most of the time I just run for it. YOLO! No! Ah! I thought I made it. Son of a bitch. You got that's like a theme in all video games. Floor burgers, wall pork chops. Just random pieces of meat found in games. What is that teaching your children? Just find a piece of meat and just eat it. Who cares? Live your life. Let's try this again. It's worth it to get hit there anyway. It doesn't matter. Come on now. Okay. There we go. Definitely dropping inputs on this. Controller's busted. Every time I'm like so tempted. Like I must kill regardless of how it's gonna damage me. Alright. What's this boss? I forget. Oh no, I made it to the house. The House on the Hell Hill. I must be doing good, because anybody else who streams, Death Road to Canada. I don't know that. I'm not familiar with that. Is anyone else who plays video games when you stream, anytime you do really well, your nose starts itching? 8671. My nose is, like, dying right now. I feel like I haven't, like, there's something in my nose physically. It drives me crazy. 8671. Not even gonna need it. One shot in this void. Oh yeah, I gotta remember to do the good ending. That's the hard part. This is it. This is the good ending. So, when you get to this part, you gotta leave. You gotta stay behind this dude. And not have him push you into this weird looking thing that's over here. Alright, I got the good ending. Well, I gotta beat this part. Thank you so much, Sanjian13, for the writing of passwords. This is where the game gets real weird. I think it might have been. Oh my god, I forgot. This part I get stuck in a lot. But this is gonna get me the good ending if I beat this level. Somehow I ended up in ancient Egypt. Come on now. And there's like all these traps in here. But I've learned the best trick is to just run like hell. I love this guitar part. YOLO. You just gotta live your life with the max. Alright, I did it. So now we all get entertained by a seductive dance by an Egyptian princess. I don't understand any of this. Like, I really don't know what this is about. Maybe it's like a Splatterhouse thing that I just don't know. But we get like this trippy music video. And she sits all kind of like, come hither. We got that mature audience warning up, right? Hashtag banned. This game just takes oh good, thank you so much for letting me know. I don't know. The other day I was streaming Loser Suit Larry on my birthday stream, and everybody was like, you're gonna get banned, you're gonna get banned. I don't know. I didn't get banned. Welcome to Egypt. I will give you a crystal ball. Good luck to you. Plot in a video game. Oh, I had to pick it up, I'm sorry. Now I just have to survive this really annoying jump sequence. These clocks from hell. Oh, you jerk. Alright, I did it. Somewhere in here there's a vending machine that I can get candy from. I've learned not to go. There's certain rooms you don't want to bother going in. I'm at max health, so it doesn't matter. Oh god, this room. Just get me out of here. No! No, 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 no! Ugh. Don't you dare! No, you prick! Don't do it! Alright, there we go. I don't want to fall down those holes. I don't know what's in there, but I know it's bad. Just run through. This is like all this. No, 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 no! I sound like my son. I have a 2-year-old, and that's his favorite word. Now, now. When he really doesn't want to do something, this is a great story. Someday he'll grow up and see this video and get really mad at me. But, my 2-year-old, when he doesn't really want to mess with something, he just says, all done. So he'll be like, all done, night-night, for like, I don't want to go to sleep. And, the other day, he was very upset that my wife made him a sandwich and she used the butt of the bread, like the little piece in the front or the back. And he kept screaming, all done butts, and I could not stop laughing. And it was making him more mad that I was laughing because he didn't understand. Alright, here's the Pumpkin King, also known as the DVD boss, and you'll see why. First off, I apologize if you have eye problems because the floor does not stop with that ridiculousness. And basically, all you need to do is stay under him. And when you hit him, then he turns into the DVD screensaver. And the only downside to this fight is you have to do it like 100 times. The big trick is to just stay right underneath him when he drops those pumpkin balls. I like dropping knowledge, so if you ever want to play this game, here's how you beat it. And you just gotta take your time. And then he becomes DVD screensaver again, and you just basically run for your life. Sometimes you get caught with that crap because you don't know where he appears. There we go. But this is it. This is the last fight. I remember the first time I played this, or we got to this part, my cousin and I did a 24-hour stream nonstop with just the two of us. And it was like 4:30 in the morning. We've been streaming nonstop. And I was so exhausted that I felt like this boss fight took 6 hours to do. So it might have. I don't even know. I was so delirious by that point. 24-hour streams is something I do not recommend anyone ever do. It's fun, but you definitely pay the price. No! Come on, meow. How many times is that? 7? I forget how many times I had to do this. Like, I think it's like 20 or something. Ugh. The Pumpkin King. Arr, I have the dumbest boss fight. I have the dumbest boss mechanic ever. Arr. But I take 1,000 hits to annoy you. That's the true torture of the Pumpkin King. And that random spawn. That's frustration. Ugh! How does he do that every time? And he always ends up in the corner, unlike the DVD screensaver. There we go. No! Stop hitting me. That one pumpkin just dawdling off. There we go. There. No. Stop it. Did I do it? No. Aw, that was cheap. Now? No. I just like boss fights that are like this. Where it's like just like real repetitive and like tedious. Now? No. Like if you do it 10 times, you should just win. Ah! Piece of crap. No. No. I know I haven't checked chat in a few minutes, I'm sorry. I'm in the fight of my life. I did it! Now everyone has an epileptic seizure, okay. Woo! Alright, well I beat 2 games tonight. That's not bad. For me, that's good. Thank you, Lester Roth. And for anybody that's joining up, my name is DonkeyShaunJr. I love to play retro games. If you're not familiar with Retro Block Party, this is a charity stream. All proceeds go to Alzheimer's Association. And also as a small incentive, if you do donate any amount of money, I will sing you a song as a thank you. Thank you, everybody. I need to shout out some people. What's up, Regal Bird? ASM Tourmund, thank you so much. The Dork Gaming, thank you so much. And we got the good ending. It was all a TV show. I fooled all of you. None of this was real. I'm Johnny Splatterhouse, MD. I don't know why it looks like I'm kind of jerking him off, but whatever. Why is he so tall and why am I so little? house. Or was it? Oh my god. Now I turned into the scary mask from Super Mario Bros. 2. Also known as the bane of my childhood existence. You know, when you pick up the key and the mask. So was it real or wasn't it? No one knows! Until Splatterhouse 2 hits. I know, I like it a lot too. See, and it was because of that thing. I don't know what this says. I think it says, and they lived happily ever after. I don't really know. For some reason, that didn't get translated in my cart. I actually really, I know it sounds lame, but I really like this ending music. It has a really nice finality. Fortunately, the movie Splatterhouse has completed. Thank you, you are great. MCC3 code by Mozilla. I love all the names. Bishibashi Haro. And they put their pictures in there. Isn't that cute? I just love this music, too. It's just like, it's just a great ending. This kind of makes me want to play Mad City. I'm going to play Trojan next. There's only 115. I could beat that pretty quick. Yeah, Anna Peruna was the music person. You did a very good job. Special thanks to Kazoo. I need to add this on my stream when I beat a game, just to play this. All right, so that was Splatterhouse or Wanpaku Graffiti. You can get there's a billion reproduction cards. You can buy the Famicom one. I think it's like $80 for like a good copy. I'm a cheapo, so I bought a repro cart for like $30. But it came with a sticker and the whole nine yards. Looks really nice. Anyway, I'm gonna switch over to Trojan, I think, next, because I really feel I have the need to beat something up. So I'm gonna try that out. I'm gonna put up my break screen for just a few seconds, so you get some cheesy elevator music while I go grab my next game, and I will be back in about, I don't know, 2 minutes. Hang on. I am back, and I am playing some Trojan. Someday I'm going to actually grow a brain and rebuild my game room so it makes sense for streaming, because everything I need to touch is, like, far away. Right now I'm remote desktop from a laptop into my streaming computer, because my streaming computer is on the other side of my room. Yes! Yes, Jared, you got it right! You're one of the only people that caught that! Yes, it's from Homestar Runner. I love it. And the music is from Leisure Suit Larry 6. So this game is Trojan. It's awesome. If you don't own this or have played this and you're a retro gamer, you really need to, because it's really, really, really fun. I gotta get used to the controls, because the controls in this game are way slower. Oh, I forgot I got the thing turned on. Take that! The other thing I never knew about this game is that there are, like, power-ups all over the game. You can get, like, powerful extra weapons and stuff. Or more powerful weapons and stuff. I had no clue. And I've been playing this game since I was a little kid. In fact, I always joke around that whenever I play it, I immediately smell... I had a neighbor. His name was Jeremy. And he was the coolest kid. He was older than me. So I just looked up to him like an idol. And he had a basement, and he had a Harlem Globetrotters pinball machine, and I kick myself every time I think about it that I never bought it. I should have bought it off of him, because it was all disrepaired. Like, it worked, but it was all messed up, and he didn't like it, so it just sat there getting destroyed, and I should have just kept it or gotten it. But we used to play this game all the time, and it's really just like Kung Fu. I mean, it's like exactly the same thing, essentially. Except for you got a sword and a shield, which doesn't really do much. And you gotta press up to jump, which is so confusing to me. There's like secret stuff in here sometimes. I don't know. Yeah, see? I never knew that those pee thing existed. I had no clue. I never knew pee existed. This music is kind of weird. Like, it's not great, but it's not terrible. Oh, this part. This boss is bullcrap. That boss is really the most annoying boss in the game, really. Because, there's no hit recovery. It's the same thing like, the last game I just played, Splatterhouse. If you get hit once, you get hit like 13 times in a row. I also love how you can, oh yeah, this is the part where you crawl inside of a big turd. And you fight Ghetto Blanca. I also love how you don't, like, stab with your sword, you just smack people with it. It's such a fun way to use a sword. Just slap the crap out of them with it. I won't kill you, but I'll smack the shiz out of you. Herp. Nice fight! You can see Capcom already starting to build out its fighting game style early on. Like, the only time I have to actually use the shield. And they don't even hit me. Oh, I see. The power thing takes less... It gives me more... It takes less hits to kill guys. That's fun. I love that boss. You just walk up to him and wail on him. Bop, 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 bop. There's also a hidden thing where there's continues in this game. I never knew that. You have to press up and start if you die. And you go to the next thing. This level is just more annoying than anything. Oh, I thought I lost my... Sometimes those guys can hit you with that red thing and it'll make you lose your sword and shield. Which is kind of fun because then you become like Street Fighter. You do jump kicks and stuff. There we go. Let me out. Cheap hit. This is the guy where you fight the big guy with the gnarled turd. You don't want to hit him. You don't want to get hit by that. That rips you up. He's like trying to hit you with a big hunk of meat. Gross. More of the same! Aw, come on, man. That was a cheap hit. You can tell this is very much just like a straight-up port from an arcade game. Where's the health at? I was on the elevator, man! Cheap. I lost my pee, too. I got no pee. The elevator trigger is very specific. It's very frustrating. I can see that it's similar to Castlevania. It's got the same wave. But I don't think it's the same tune. Oh my god, Ghosts and Goblins, no. There isn't enough... That was failure. You can't pay me enough to try to stream that. I mean, I've streamed it before, but I would feel so embarrassed trying to play it, because I could barely get out of the third level. I just gotta get through. This is like the most annoying part level in the game. This gauntlet thing. Because you just get ripped up, like, really easily. You just get on the wrong side of RNG and that's it, like this part. And now you get to fight Trojan! He reminds me of some bratty little kid. He's like, take that. Like, he's one of those kids when you'd be fighting him, and he'd be like, time out. And then he would pick a rock up or something and be like, time in. We all have people like that, you know it. This guy's all about the jump in. I don't know how he manages to slide backwards without moving his legs, but that's cool. Must be some kind of ice thing he's got. Yeah! I did it! Looks everyone good morning, I like it. Time out, time in. I love that. I can fight you and I can use a baseball bat and you can't use anything. I'm gonna go down here. Sure. Just some random guy hiding out in the sewer. Hey guys. See, now I got speed. I'm fast. I never knew any of this existed in this game. There we go. I mean, I never got this far in the game when I was a little kid, so. No. I guess it kind of comes with the territory. Go down here, too. Thanks, guys. I got a free bat. And some rats. Bats and rats. It's a video game. Beedy, beedy, beedy. Oh, it took me all the way back here? That's crap. Oh wait, I gotta fight another boy here. Ugh! That is so annoying. That guy, so far fighting that guy, I have not, you haven't seen the insanity that he can pull off if you get hit by him. Because as soon as he gets hit, his fist, that flying thing that comes out, comes right back to him, so he can throw it right away. So if you're not careful, he can take half your life away in 1 second. This is just insanity, you just run for your life. And then I gotta fight crappy Blanca again. Bop! Hey! And again. And again. That's weird. He usually goes back and forth a couple of times. And last time, a couple of times he didn't. This game's glitched, dude. Olay! Come on, meow. Okay, so up we go. Another boss fight, maybe? I forget. Yeah, I gotta fight the goblin guy again. If you're quick, though, you can just wail on him like that. Oh, man. Oh, applications are open for the next retro block party. I gotta get going on that. If you're a retro streamer and you're just even remotely considering it, I can't recommend doing it enough. It's so much fun. You get to hang out with awesome people, play some really fun games, raise money for a good cause. It's totally awesome. Come on up. If I can go fast enough, I can get it. I don't really think that does anything, but I like getting it. Come on, Trojan. Got him in a loop, I think. Yeah, all right. Excitement, excitement. Sir Frank Honor, I'm doing well. I don't know if you're asking everybody, but why not? I got the mic so I can talk. I'm doing pretty well. This is the most annoying music in the game. They're like, you're trying to beat this game now. I'm just going to go with straight audio torture. Yeah, my week was pretty good. I actually took most of the week off because it was my birthday on Wednesday. And I always kind of take a day off on my birthday because it's my birthday. You know, Valentine's Day with my wife, we're pretty laid back with that stuff, so it wasn't anything crazy. Cooked a nice dinner for her. Helped put the kids to bed, which I don't do often because I'm always doing stuff. Like streaming or whatever. She's kind of more the nighttime person, but I helped out because I always feel bad. And plus, it's actually kind of fun with my two kids, especially my 7-month-old. She's, like, so funny. Unintentionally funny. Like, you see that I kind of have this beard, right? She, or like her favorite thing on earth is to smile at me, grab both sides of my beard as hard as she can, pull my face towards her, and scream right in my face. She just loves it. It's so much fun. Every time I love it. This level, this is the bullshit level, because I there's a very likely chance I will die on this part. Why am I jumping all high? It's because the mechanic for the shield is so slow. But I gotta get through it with some health. Because the only way I learned how to beat these guys is just bum rush the shit out of them. You gotta stay back when they break through the Nestle Crunch Bar wall, because those things will actually hit you. I swear to God, they did it on purpose because they knew the enemies were really bad. But you gotta be quick. If you're quick, you can totally do it. Yeah! And now you get to fight Achilles! And he throws off his jacket that looks like a condom of some sort. And now you're in the fight of your life. You gotta be careful, because his swings will rip you apart if you're not careful. Come on now. I need to let him out more. You just gotta jump in on him. That's all I've ever done to beat him. Come on. Oh, see? One hit. Come out of the corner is the problem, I think. Come on now. I'm getting nervous because my cart keeps flashing and makes me really scared. Bah! He slaughtered me. Rip. Why am I getting no luck on this? I'm trying to go, like, ahead of it, because I'm, like, wondering if that's a problem. I don't know, it's weird. I usually hit him by once by now. It's so fast, you have no chance. You're just dead. I wonder if, hang on a sec. I wonder if Turbo's screwing me up. Because I usually don't play this game with Turbo on. Let me try that. It's actually not that bad. You just gotta like, there we go. That's the problem. I had Turbo on. That's what was fucking it up. It's all about the jump in with him and then just stay out of the way. If you get hit by him, you're done. That was what the problem was. I wasn't extending my sword all the way. Bop, 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 bop. Thanks to you, we have finally defeated Achilles! The world will be in peace again. We praise your love and courage that has carried us through our desperate struggle. Huh? I did it. And now I get to learn about all the characters. I love these when you beat the game and you get the cast of characters. Mamushi! Iron Arm! Man boobs. This guy's French Canadian. Armadillo. And he's all like, rawr! That walk cycle was something else. Goblin. The guy with the large stick of meat. It's like a Slim Jim. Muscular. Then you fight Trojan, which I'm confused. I thought I was Trojan. He looks like he's got problems. This guy. King Shriek. And Crazy Walk Cycle Man. Achilles. And then you beat it. And that's it. Oh, Sam the Game Man, I am not good at games. I'm what I like to call a slugger. I like to slug my way through games. And I play these games a lot. But I appreciate it. I appreciate the fact that I get to show off that I can beat some... I was able to gain some catharsis in my life from when I was a young fourth and fifth grader who was pulling his hair out. Somewhere I still have my controller with teeth marks in it because I bit a controller trying to beat a game. I got so mad. What do I want to do next? I could do Jaws. I could do Mad City. I could do... How much time? Look, I got plenty of time. I'm debating. Jaws, Mad City. I don't really feel like playing Kung Fu. I could beat that pretty easily, but that's not like that's kind of a wussy thing. I always save that for the end if I'm in a vamp. If you ever see me on my regular stream and I'm playing Kung Fu, you know that I ran out of ideas. Let's do Mad City. Hold on. Let me go grab the cartridge. I'll be back in 2 seconds. In the meantime, enjoy this really cheesy break song. All right, I am back. So this game is Mad City, and I am a champion for this game because it is The Adventures of Bobby Billy, but the non-terrible version. So if you don't know, it's rumored, but thank you. I love that the elevator music. It's from Leisure Suit Larry 6, Shape Up or Slip Out, Lester Roth. So in Japan... They didn't have video game rentals like they did in the United States, like West Coast Video. Like, we all would go there, pay $5 to get a game. And the rumor is that in Konami's world, they were terrified of this game rental industry because they thought that people were just going to rent games and they never make any money. Yes, I call it the good version of the game we know. So the rumor has always been that Konami turned up the difficulty on certain games and re-engineered some of the games for American release to make it more difficult. And The Adventures of Bayou Billy is one of those rumored games. I can tell you that I can beat Mad City on a good day. I can beat it. Oh, crap. Hang on a sec. I got to switch controllers. Hold up. Sorry about that. I switched to my Famicom, so I needed to switch controllers. But anyway, like on a good day, I can beat this game maybe dying once. And The Adventures of Bayou Billy, the American version, I can, if I'm lucky, I get to the driving stage. If I'm lucky. I mean, I haven't played it in a while, so maybe I'm better at it now, but it's just insanely difficult. The enemies take so many hits. You're basically jump kicking the entire game because it's the only way you can survive. But the Japanese version is the great, is the good version. I've always actually wanted to see if I could pay somebody to, like, make a translated game. Like, make Mad City, but translated into English. So it would basically be The Adventures of Bayou Billy, but not the crap version. Alright, so here we go. If you play The Adventures of Bayou Billy, you know the game. You're basically, like, Crocodile Dundee, but you're running around just beating the crap out of people. Because somebody stole your woman, and he hired an entire armada of people to keep you away from her. But all the enemies, like, that guy took 2 jump kicks, as opposed to, like, 7, which is what the American version is. There's more health pickups. The driving stage, you have life, as opposed to just one-shot kills. There's no mandatory fighting of the alligators or crocodiles. I don't know what they are, but I'm assuming gators. I just got hit in the face by a bird. More meatballs. All my games have meatballs in them for some reason tonight. Even the guy, like, if you watch, it was a while back, but someone did this on Awesome Games Done Quick, and even he struggled on it. Trying to beat it, and he's like a pro speedrunner, and he was still like, yeah, this game, if I can get out of the first level, I might be able to beat it. But this version is easy peasy. Much more my stream. Oh, AquaJu, thank you so much for the raid. That's awesome. Well, you're half right. It's the Japanese version, because it's the one I can beat. The American version, I can't even get close. Stupid American version. I hope, the only concern I have is I picked the wrong game mode, because I don't have, that was bad gaming right there. Because I do not have a light gun, so I hope I got that, I hope I picked the right one. Because if not, I'm going to have to be using my resetting stick. By the way, for those of you that are just joining, I do have a small donation incentive that, if you donate any amount, which all proceeds go to Alzheimer's, I forget what it is, Alzheimer's Research, the exact title, but I will sing you a song as a thank you. And I'm not totally terrible at singing. I'm better at singing than I am at video games, if that's any indicator. But I used to, when I was a kid, I had the American version of this game, and I loved it, but I couldn't get past the first level. It was so freaking hard. I thought the alligators were the boss of the game. Come on, man. Get me out of this. I just jump kick my way through the swamp. That's how I live my life today. All right. Great soundtrack, and I love the game because it has, like, a what I call a triple threat. In that you got, like, shooting, and you got driving, and you got beat-em-ups. You got, like, you got it all. It gives you the full package, which I love. I really wish I knew what that guy said right there. All right, here we go. I love how I have a six shooter, but I can shoot rapid. I can shoot real fast. Must be belt fed. Now I can just take my sweet ass time. This game also has this cool thing where if I don't miss, I don't lose any bullets. Which is really fun. That is true. I mean, I don't really know anything about guns, so I shouldn't really talk about it. Ah, you jerk. Yeah, so if you see I'm at 182, I stay at 182 until I miss. That's how it works. It took me a while to figure out too. And then this thing gives you the hourglass gives you infinite ammo. So now I can just pepper the whole planet. There's absolutely nothing left. I almost feel like this was built for a different game because it has health like med kits as opposed to the health like meat. Again, another game with meat. I don't know any trick for that boss other than just hold down the B button and pray. Yeah, I never knew. I honestly, Senjian, I didn't know that either for a while. But then I realized I wasn't running out of ammo, ever. And I was like, there has to be a reason why, because I only have so many bullets and I would be shooting like crazy. Oh yeah, we were questioning about how fast we could shoot with a six shooter. This is the only boss in the game that proves to be a challenge. In both versions. Sometimes you can luck out and you can just kick the shit out of him before he gets there. If you're lucky. BDD. Here he comes. Goldberg. Because he's got that throw, and that's the problem. That throw is so frustrating. Sometimes you can glitch him, and you can get a lot of kicks in. That helped. But that throw just equalizes it, like, right off the bat. It's the only fight I have troubles on. It's so annoying. Yes. You basically have infinite shot. You're correct. It rewards your accuracy, I guess would be the best way to put it. All right, whatever. Stage 4. The driving is the most different in the game compared to the American version. You throw dynamite instead of grenades. Some the enemies, like, you can shoot them and some you can't. I don't understand. I think the enemy you can't shoot is actually the getaway truck with the girl in it, I think. You shoot way slower. You have health. It's way easier, too. In my opinion, at least. Don't hit the rock, don't hit the rock. I literally dropped bombs on top of you. Did you ever just think about the logistics of this right now? Like, so this guy kidnapped my girl. And I'm after her. And so far, I've beaten about 15 different, I'll say 25 guys. Blown up an airplane, shot about 100 people. I've blown up like 4 or 5 cars. I'm just saying, I don't know where this guy gets all his money. At the end of the game, I got to fight the two guys from Universal Soldier. They must cost a lot of money, like Van Damme and Dolph Lundgren. They're not coming in cheap. Crazy. Well, that's true. Sorry, I'm catching up. It is Man versus the World. It is definitely an American action movie trope. But you gotta love it. I guess it is kind of like Sylvester Stallone when he decided to take on the entire Russian army in Rambo 3. One of the best lines in movies. Troutman looks at him and he goes, "What do you think?" And he loads his gun. Fuck him. Well, Van Damme now, but I'm talking Van Damme and when the muscles from Brussels was at his peak of power. This is my favorite song in the game. It just reminds me of going to Pizza Hut on a Friday night. Like, this is the song you would listen to in the drive over or at the restaurant. Because when Pizza Hut ruled the world. Does anyone remember? I know this is going to make me seem... I mean, I turned 38 this week, so I'm old as shit. But, does anyone remember when you used to do... I don't know if they even still do it, but the reading competition thing in school, where you would read books, and if you did really well, you would get free pizza from Pizza Hut. That was, like, the best. That was the most competitive thing I ever did in my life. I read, like, 15,000 books. But the thing that bothered me was there was this one kid in my class with me, and he would always beat me by like 10 books, and I know he was cheating. His mom made all that up. There's no way he read that many books. He would have to have stayed up like 24 hours a day to keep up. Sorry, I'm catching up on chat. Oh, we're still discussing the logistics of this gun. What kind of gun that he has. Oh my god, yes! Ramming on the back of the... And when he... spoiler alert. When he rams the gunship with a tank... Oh my god, it's the most machismo thing I've ever seen in my life. It was second only to Rocky IV. Oh, you jerk! The car got me. Rocky IV might actually be the most ridiculous film I've ever seen. It's just pure insanity. We're almost there, boys. We're at Mad City! We made it. That stinks. Pizza Hut used to be, like, I mean, I know it's terrible pizza, but that was, like, the big, man. You got that free pizza, you felt like a god. I cheered for the scene. That's so sad. Well, now we're in Mad City, where everything's mad. The people are mad, the drinks are mad, it's all mad. These guys are scumbags, they're pickpockets, they got knives. Excuse me, when you're not looking, they shank you. Jerks. Even though the game's easier, I always do it. No! Get away from me, chest man. Even though the game's easier, I still jump kick everybody at all times. Because nothing was more badass than jump kicking somebody. That's when you knew you're like, no matter what, if there was a fight and the jump kick came out, whoever got kicked was losing. Give me that meat. I want that to happen to me in real life, where I jump kick someone so hard that a leg of lamb falls out of their pocket, and then I eat it in front of them and become even more powerful. Well, the game is now almost over because I now have the best weapon in the game, because I can attack people from across the screen, even though it's not very strong. You just whip the shit out of people. This is how the all Indiana Jones movie should be. Just this. You just walk down the street just whipping the shit out of people. Jazz bar. Basically, it is. You're right. It is basically Indiana Jones. I mean, I kind of look the part, too. Actually, I'm almost convinced. If you go look up, there's a Famicom Disk System, Moon Konami, called Miracle of Almana. If you've never played it, it is great. It's actually the Indiana Jones game that I've always wanted. But your sprite looks a lot like that sprite from that character, just more detailed. Come on now. I'm in trouble. These guys are beating the bejesus out of me. Now I got a gun. Oh wait, that guy's got a bulletproof vest on. Hold on. Take that, you dingus. Miracle of Almana, by the way, is also a top five game in my life. There's a... I died. There's a great site. It's called The Nest Dump. That does one of the best reproductions of that game ever. English translation, does the book, like the instruction manual in English. It's like one of the best reproduction cards I've ever seen. Oh, please give me that whip. There we go. You strip him, then you whip him. I like it. Now we're up to the second gun stage, so we can talk more about guns. Wait. Hey, I've got your girl. Oh no, I gotta move fast. I only got 5 minutes. Eh. Go faster. I got like two more levels. Yeah! Now I'm shooting up Bourbon Street. This part of the game is really fun because the last boss, the boss at the end of this is the, it's twins. You fight Arnold and Danny DeVito. If I can get there. And the other thing I forgot, one other key difference in this game is that, the ending, there's three different endings you can get. You can get the good ending, which is what I always do, where you rescue your girl. There's one where you run away, and she says, like, you're a jerk, and then you leave her, and then there's a third one. I forget what you do, I think you kick her. And you get in trouble. I think that's how it works. Ooh, extra life. But anyway, if you're an Adventures of Bobby Billy fan, I would extremely highly recommend this game. Or this version of the game, because I find it vastly superior to the American one. Well, now I'm invincible. I'm just going to save bullets. Because I'm low on ammo. This part is like real stingy with ammo. And I gotta make sure I have plenty left for the last fight because I blow through it really fast. And if I run out of ammo, then the game's over, so that's kinda lame. No! Oh wait! Oh my god, I'm like dying. Derp. I totally just blew that too. All right, Danny DeVito, here we go. Oh, he got me. That was too fast. I don't think I'm going to make it. I'm not going to be able to beat this in time. I only have 2 minutes, I think. Shoot! Oh, well. Well, I'll get as far as I can. Hopefully we can... I'll go quick. Or as quick as the game, stupid game will let me. Now I'm fighting Danny DeVito. Alright. The penultimate stage. I made it to. So close. Just go! My only goal in this is to, get a whip. Because I lost my whip. There we go. Oh, there's my cat. Hey, kitty. All right, well, I got that at least. Yes. No. My cat feels my stress, so he's trying to make me feel better. Aw, thanks, kitty. Oh, thank you so much, Old Drippy Drip, for the raid! No! Come on, now. I feel so bad you gotta kill these dogs. I mean, you don't kill them, you just make them sleep. Alright, I made it to the end. Thank you, kitty. My cat has a stress disorders or whatever, so when I get stressed, he comes over and he tries to make me feel better. I'm alright, kitty. You're okay. Say hi to everybody. Alright, I made it to stage 9. This is the last fight. I can beat this out. I gotta kill two guys. I gotta kill Danny DeVito again. Come on now. No. The only hard part is you gotta stay away from him when he does that, when he pulls your hat. That's really the only part, other than hitting him, is annoying. But he doesn't seem to want to stay away from me tonight, so. And then I gotta rope-a-dope the two guys from Universal Soldier. No, give me that! If you lose the whip, the fight becomes so obnoxious because you can only jump kick him. No. Yes, alright, now Universal Soldier time. I'm going so fast. So this is the Sean trick right here. What you do is you get them both on one side and then you do the rope-a-dope. You just gotta stay away from him as much as you can. My cat rules. His name's Kitty. He was in adoption. He's a snowshoe Siamese. He has a lot of anxiety disorder, so like when you yell and stuff, he gets really freaked out. But other than that, he's a great cat. Super friendly. He's an older cat. I love him most of the time, except for when he bumps into my microphone like right now. Stop it. Come on, rope-a-dope. The reason why you want to do this is because they have this one move where if one of them will grab you and the other one will go on the other side and beat you up, and not only does it take like a ton of life away, but you lose the whip. And if you lose the whip, you got to jump kick the whole fight, and it's just like a hand destroyer. It rips your fingers apart. Kitty, stop it. I love you, buddy. You got to relax. Everything's good. We got this. You've seen me beat this before. Oh my god, I'm so close. That's what she said. Come on now, come on now. How are these guys still both alive? Usually one of them dies. Hey, what's going on?
Hi. Not much. How was your stream?
It's very good. I just beat it. I beat the last game I was going to do.
Oh, perfect. I literally just pulled it off. You haven't beaten it yet for my visuals, but I'm glad you did. Yay, there congrats. It
is. Thank you. I did the good ending too, so we won out.
Yeah. Let's chill out until the credits play a little bit then. Okay. I didn't realize you were so close.
I was scrambling because I looked over and I was like, oh my god, it's 10 of. I don't know if I'm going to be 2 levels in 10 minutes. I don't know if I can do it, but I was close.
Congratulations!
I went 3 over. Thank you. It was exciting. I was happy to go 3 for 3 tonight. All right, kitty. Go live your life.
That's okay. Sam's Tim had to pee anyway. So perfect. I was like, yeah, we'll give him a couple extra minutes. So perfect.
Perfect.
Everybody, can we get some GGs in chat for Sean?
Aw, thanks, everybody. So yeah, to conclude, if you don't have this game, you should get Mad City because it's actually better than The Adventures of Bobby Billy. And you get the most awesome... Listen to this 80s music outro at the end. Like, that's straight out of Dirty Dancing. Like, Swayze would dance to this. It's so good. Thank you, everybody, for all the GGs. I appreciate it greatly.
Well, how was your segment other than beating the game?
It was awesome. It was a lot of fun. You? I accomplished what I had set out to do. I managed to get a couple of donations, which is amazing, and I got to play a lot of really fun video games and have some good chats.
And you got to sing a little bit too.
So that was pretty cool. Couple of thank you songs. So that was it was totally worth it.
Hold on, I'm going crazy because I'm listening to myself 3 times. I can do it twice, but 3 is too many.
Oh my god. Hey, I can't even imagine.
Congratulations. Did you have any last words you wanted to say about the charity or about Alzheimer's or
I just wanted
anything?
To say that Retro Block Party is literally one of the best organizations I've ever interacted with like in my life, and that it's a privilege and an honor to get picked, and it's a privilege to be a part of it, and just the fact that we can raise so much money for different charities like every month is just an amazing feeling. It's really great, and I appreciate everybody that came out to watch. I hope that the people that were there that watched had a good time watching, and weren't totally bored out of your minds. But it was a blast, and you know, Alzheimer's affects so many people. I know. I have family members that are affected by it, so there's a little bit of extra motivation for this because I know how difficult it can be to see somebody who suffers from it, and if there's any way that this amount of money can help find a cure or ease that problem or ease those issues, that means a lot.
Yeah, exactly. That's like for the charity is the whole reason why we do this.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and bring Sam into our conversation.
Awesome.
He'll probably be mid-talking with Wolf, but I'm giving him some time to realize that we're talking about him. So, there we go. Okay. Hi, Sam!
Hi!
Hey, you're up next. What are you going to play for us?
I'm going to be playing Sonic Spinball, and if the miracle happens that I have time after that, I'll be doing Knuckles in Sonic 2.
Nice, awesome. Absolutely. Jake has been saying for a while now that he would donate money to anybody that can beat that game. So, do you think you're going
to
do that?
Yeah, I'm calling him out. Yeah, I'm going to try to call him out. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's get rocking and rolling. Thank you again, Sean, for being on here. It was great being able to watch your segment and everything.
Yeah, it was my pleasure.
I'm going to have you count down from 5, and then you're going to stop streaming.
Okay. Have a great stream coming up, Sam, and have a great night, everybody. 5.